What's going on, everybody? It's Frito here for Your Overwatch. In today's video, we're going to be discussing what I think is quite an important meta consideration for the state of the game. Info that I think is going to help you on all roles, no matter what one you play, to understand where the carry in the game is, so you know what you should be focusing on in order to better help your team win. Recently, I conducted a poll to ask you guys who you thought was the strongest role for solo queue. And I was shocked by this response because, well, first of all, if players thought tanks were this powerful, why don't they play them, right? That's just sort of a weird thing. But I think what has happened is that the community's perception of tank characters has not changed with the times. If this were a year ago, I definitely would say that tanks are incredibly powerful. And if your Rein was better than the enemy Rein, the gap was so big that it was hard for your team to lose. But the truth is, after repeated nerfs and sort of the mix-up of the state of the meta, main tanks especially are perceived to be basically useless at higher tiers. I discussed this recently, and I think part of the phenomenon is healing in the game went down, so characters that are the best at absorbing healing, main tanks, lost some value, but also their barriers went down. And on top of that, the structure of the gameplay has made it a bit more difficult to find kills, so because of that, a lot of focus from the game goes onto the main tank. So the byproduct of this is that teams with map control have a much easier route to value because there isn't the excessive amount of tanking to deny it. In many ways, this is a very good thing for the game of Overwatch, but I think it's been quite a shock to the community how much better squishies especially have to play and fend for themselves without the very forgiving nature of older versions of protection from the tank position to cover up their positional weaknesses. But the funny thing that has happened with the ranked meta anyway is that most tank players are seeing better success just fragging out on characters like Sigma, Wrecking Ball, and especially Roadhog, despite being nerfed, because of how difficult teamwork now is and teamwork-based comps, at least with random teammates. It used to be a lot of teamwork-based characters just were statistically better than many others, meaning that they were ranked meta just based on how much guaranteed value you'd get out of having like a main tank. But now the ranked experience is asking a very different thing from tank players, because if you're in solo queue and you want to carry as a tank, the thing that you're going to notice is that if you play a main tank, you are almost entirely dependent on your supports knowing how to get value out of it. The truth is, if you're going to have a main tank, your supports need to know how to go create eliminations for the team. If they don't, and the enemy team doesn't play a main tank, but instead plays more off-tank, deathmatchy style comps, they're simply going to be able to frag better than you can. And what this has done in the ranked community is assume that balance is to blame for main tanks being so weak, but I'm not so sure I believe that. And I'm hoping maybe even with this video that we can spur a little bit of momentum in the community to adapt our playstyles to the way the game plays now and realize in the mix-up of the power down era of the game, supports lost a bit of healing, but it was actually the tanks that caught the brunt of that L. But supports still retained a lot of their offense capabilities. Their cooldowns largely remained the same as far as I remember. Mostly healing values was the thing that was tuned down. So because of that, the support that plays more actively to find offensive value has a potential to take over the whole game. That's the whole thing about space in Overwatch. What are you making space four? It has always been so that your team's attacks have the positioning to be set up easily. But there's a big perception problem, I think, in our community where players, as they've said in this poll, think that supports are the weakest role in the game when in reality they're the strongest. And what happens is if you play a role assuming it's weak, you're going to be playing more passively and more scared rather than trying to make a play yourself. And that's why I'm not exactly too sure where the death of main tanks is coming from. A lot of players think it's just the meta, but at the same time, as I was catching L's on main tank all last season, I go back and look at VOD reviews and I see supports playing in a pure passive way. And this is something that has made me feel alienated from the tank role and instead decided I'm going to take matters into my own hands, apply the principles that I think support should be doing, making use of their tank space and getting aggression, I've switched to playing support, and I've instantly been carrying in the lobbies that I was previously losing for free as tank. I have a 60%+ win rate as Ana. I'm nearly GM again after taking a break from support and focusing on losing on other roles for a while. And to sort of describe this for you guys, this game of Havana is one where I felt I was playing Winston about as well as I could, but due to how my team wanted to play, Winston just can't be an option. And no example is more clear to me than this Streets phase fight, where I was surprised at how difficult it was to clean up and win a fight we were winning handily. And this is sort of one of the problems with Overwatch, is that you can win while making horrific mistakes that are going to instantly lose in different situations. What's happening here is anytime I push up to get space for the team, our team doesn't actually take it. This was so shocking to me to see this, and to see this repeatedly in so many of my games last season. If I go fight their backline and their tank peels for me, just this positioning alone should be a victory for the team. As a tank, if you pull aggro away from the cart, away from the center of the map, and things chase you and you survive and get out and get healed, well, this should be an easy win. But as it turns out, we have to get so many more kills and play so much better just to win this point. And the reason is our supports just don't know where to stand. They don't know where they should be to maximize their impact. Look at how far back during all of this chaos my Zen was. This is what I would describe as positioning to AFK. Discord's one of the best abilities in the game, and we're not in a position anywhere to cast it effectively. And in fact, playing this low ground like this means that any stall that they send out more easily finds us. Whereas if our Zen and Ana are up on the high ground with our Zarya or Widowmaker, then they can see everything, right? They can contribute. But it's this tendency for support players to hide in the safest position possible to be effectively AFK that makes them so weak. Rather than stepping into the play and interacting with what's going on, I see this so often that they're just looking for a hole to hide in, as opposed to a power position to control and make plays from. This is why, to me, I think main tanks are basically unplayable, because if you go in as a main tank and your supports aren't tossing out damage in discords or landing an anti into the backline while everything peels for you, well, you're gonna have a hard time. But I wonder if main tank would still be playable if we had playmaking support players, like if our community was better at it. And I am working on a much more in-depth Ana mastery guide, because knowing how important it is for the support position to make plays, when I go into ranked and do that, even though it's not my traditional role, it feels like easy mode in comparison to playing tank. Because the problem I have with tank is I am beholden to where my supports want to play and their playstyle. Unless you just play a deathmatch tank and pop off. And like the clips I showed you, it's a struggle to get my team into position if they don't know what a good position is. And this is like a perfect example of what I mean. I see this happen at low ranks so often, where you take a map like Gibraltar or Dorado, and a team is using early high ground on the cart. And it's not supposed to be good, but it ends up working because the players don't know the answer to it. And what you see is that the whole team focuses the cart, puts all their energy into the cart, while the enemy has better angles to shoot down on them. Which means we can effectively kill nothing other than the early pick I got. But because they still have positioning, they're able to res. The thing I like about support is that in the support position right now, if you know that tanks are weak, you don't actually have to pocket tanks in terrible positions. You can just go get better positions and get more value from them. If I were to focus all of my resources onto my Reinhardt, I just keep him up a bit longer. We don't actually effectively kill anything. And him pushing up into a bad angle is straight up just a waste of time. I think a lot of players think of Overwatch in terms of man advantage. And that's the first early understanding of how the game's supposed to be played. Just keep your team alive, and if the enemy team dies, then we'll be able to win. But with how Overwatch has been rebalanced, positioning matters so much more than man advantage. Which is why what I do as support is force my team to come take the better ground if they want to or not. I will just stand off in a corner and spam come this way until they come and cash in the free team fight win I'm begging them to take. Because imagine if I stayed on this low ground, after we got our pick, they would have still rezzed, right? But it's me and the Zarya going up to the high ground, being in close range, landing our abilities, that makes it easy. This is what I mean. And this is the type of stuff I'm asking my supports to do. And I don't think it's very difficult, but when the whole community has the mentality that supports are these precious snowflakes, that if you breathe on them, they'll melt. No, supports are DPS characters with healing abilities. That's how powerful they are. They are dual roles in Overwatch. They do everything. So just go into positions to do the everything and carry the game. Now here's an example of me doing this in a ranked game. Keep in mind, I'm high masters, nearly GM, like one game away right now. What I noticed early on in this Rialto game is that my Risa doesn't know how to play her character. But thankfully for us, if you were to pick one character on your team to absolutely be throwing by playing so badly that they're just feeding, you would want it to be the main tank because they do the least to win the game anyway. Here, what we're seeing our Risa do is make the mistake of assuming they're playing double shield in like a year ago. You as Orisa with just your one flimsy shield and a Roadhog here means that this isn't a bunker comp necessarily, it's just a poke comp. The only advantage you have with these tanks is your damage and setting up your Roadhog to find kills. Or, you know, using the shield for your Widow to get kills. Your whole existence as main tank, picking any of them, is so that other players can get kills easier. It is not to absorb damage. And that's what you're gonna notice my Risa teammate continues to do by just jumping into lines of sight where she can be shot rather than hiding and anchoring a position. That's what Orisa's good at, and that's what like characters like Brig or Reinhardt are good at right now. You never want to just absorb poke. That's not good. Like, you're not gaining anything by poking the enemy with 11 damage a hit while they can insta-kill you. That's a throw. So when I noticed my Orisa started doing this, listen, there is no way that you as the Ana player can focus your attention on pocketing a throw position. It is not possible. This is what one of the greatest things about support, and I learned this by playing with some higher level players that, funnily enough, in top 500, players oddly just throw randomly all the time because they're so good that if they wanna say F you to another player, they just throw the game because they expect to be able to grind their way back up to SR anyway. So throwing is very common, but I had a teammate who was throwing and it was drawing my APM to try to heal them. And my teammate said, don't heal the thrower, heal us so we can make plays. That isn't something that just works at the highest tiers. It works at every tier. And in fact, it's easier the lower rank you are because your opponents won't be as skilled. So you can accomplish even more with less help from teammates. Well, our Orisa here is positioning to be able to take maximum damage, which is the worst thing a tank could do in this position. If you see where our Hog or Brig or I am positioning on this checkpoint hold, if we hold around the corner, we can touch the cart and force the enemy to rush into us and our value and our abilities. Whereas if our Orisa runs out towards the entire enemy team, there is nothing I can do, even with Nano, that is going to protect her. There is no way that she either stays alive or even gets any value because she's running into the enemy's shields and barriers when really her biggest strength would be to use Fortify where I'm standing right now on this corner to survive and stall the cart and like pull aggro in and land a halt so someone else can get a kill. The Orisa's not good at getting kills. The Orisa's good at stalling. So the absolute worst thing the Orisa could do is move our formation out into all of the line of fire rather than maximizing the natural cover we have in this frankly overpowered defending position. It should never be easy for the attacking team to cap Rialto A without expending a ton of resources because all you have to do is hide around a corner and you stall the cart. Like, they have to run into your angles. Why would you want to run into theirs, right? We don't have to attack into them. They have to attack into us. So as I play through ranked, it's a bit surprising to me the combination of both how bad some high ranked players are, but also how easy it is to carry from the right positions. So here on streets, Orisa is attempting to do the same wrong things again and again, jumping into the biggest angle, not fortifying the strong position. The strongest position on Streets phase here is this staircase. It is an impenetrable fortress that most, if not all of your attention should go on controlling because you can navigate it in the way that I am in order to find angles and openings offset of the opponent's defenses. But instead of using that staircase cover point, my Orisa is just on constant retreat mode just to get shot, right? Like, we're not actually making space. But despite that, because I and our Roadhog are constantly trying to use good space. Even though our Orisa is throwing, it doesn't matter. Like, she's still gonna get carried in this game. It would have been way easier if our Orisa on third now, if she fortifies this corner, it gives us a place to launch our abilities from. But instead, she's just jumping into all of the damage. Like, if you see a teammate doing this, you can't pocket them. There's no way. You're not going to carry them by pocketing their bad position, right? What we need to do is lurk around on the backside of the fight and find value to frag while she's getting shot. And the reason why I bring this up is that a lot of players think that what I'm saying you should do is a throw, right? They think you should just stick on your tank's bad positioning and pocket them as hard as you can. That does not win. I know, because this season has been hilariously easy as I play support with this in mind, knowing how weak tanks are and how important it is not to pocket the thing out of position, but to make a play from a good position. And frankly, sacrificing a teammate, if I have to, in order to make a bigger play elsewhere in the fight. That's the power of the support position right now. You have all of the tools to decide who lives or dies on your team, while also having the offense to create eliminations. The thing that shocks me is that I don't even feel particularly good at support. I've played it the least of the three roles, and it does seem like I have a knack for Ana. I think I got that from playing Brig. She teaches you a lot of timings on how to get big value on abilities. That's where that comes from. Like, my Ana abilities are strong, but I think I'm seeing a lot of success in ranked mainly because I have this different perspective on what the support role is supposed to do, or at least can do outside of the highest tiers of play. When you get up to like top 500, you're not gonna need to be the one to go after these positions because the right teammates will already do it. Either the tanks or the DPS will already be holding power positions, so the supports can play more supportive. But outside of that rank, support characters are so strong that they can just play like a DPS playstyle anyway. Now, for sure, I will admit that playing this way puts you at much greater risk. So there's certain picks like Widowmaker, for example, that really punishes you trying to take an angle and make a play. But my opinion is it is better for you to land a sick anti that confirms kills for your team a lot of times than it is for you to never land a sleep or an anti and just survive and heal. Most of the time, that is a losing formula that makes your tank's job harder, not easier. Like, you think if you just survive and heal them, they'll be fine. But the problem is they can't hold up. Like, they don't have the defenses to hold position. And if the enemy hits an anti on them or lands some abilities or someone gets a pick and the fight breaks out, which so often happens, you can't merely just play to survive. You need to be aiding in the elimination battle. You have to contribute. And I will admit, our support playing community very likely will begin to attempt to do what I'm saying and do it badly, die, and think it's either the wrong thing to do or lose rank in the short term. But I think the players that do develop this sense of playmaking and realizing the requirement of the position, they will start to weed out these more passive players that are taking up some of these higher ranked positions. It is for sure the more dangerous and more skillful way to play. I just think there's no way to get away from it, right? It's like, if you pick Widowmaker, you know you have to go get angles and find kills at the right time for impact for the team. Playing Ana is no different to me. It's exactly the same thing, but you also heal your team and, you know, have different abilities and whatnot. But it's a very similar approach to playing the game for impact. And I think for the most part, almost all of the supports fit this mold. Brig is a little different. Mercy is obviously different. But Zen, Bap, Lucio, Moira, they all go in this category. As I've been switching to support this season, it's just so evident the power share the support position has in winning the tank battle. Because tanks struggle to get kills without them or die for free without their play. As I've said, with more focus fire going onto tanks, they draw most of the aggro easily. So it is on you as a support player to be in position to bail them out when that happens. The whole support lineup is just really strong and hard to counter or it's hard for the enemy to find a team composition that makes all support heroes kind of weak. Whereas the tank position, it's very easy to find a couple picks that marks the tank. And that's a very important term in Overwatch. You can think of it as like the term check in chess, where you're one step away from winning and the enemy has to respond to block or dodge you putting their king in check. The entire tank role pretty easily gets put in check right now. And it's mainly by either the baseline power of DPS or the ceiling power of supports. And what I mean is, there's a lot of fairly easy DPS that deny tanks from pressing W. They're not necessarily the top meta, win every game, beat everything type character, but they still make tanks' life miserable, whether it be Mei, Sombra, Reaper, Torbjorn. There's a lot of these types of picks where Reaper just exists and you have to kind of run from him a lot of the time as a tank player. There's a few tanks you can pick to try to out mechanic him, but largely he's hunting you down and getting a lot of easy value on your face. And when the enemy plays these tank busty or tank disabling characters, it's on your team's squishies to step up with either the range damage or the abilities that deny them. Tanks don't have a lot of tools other than Sigma's fragging, hog hooks, or wrecking balls, adaptive shield being over the top, insane amounts of health. Beyond that, it's on the team to be able to counter those things. Then one step further, because shielding is so low in the game, it's hard for the tank character to protect the team from hitscan threats. And it's on the squishies of the team to interact with that battle, because the hitscans are often too far for the tank to progress and not leave a gap open, because they have to aggress, right? They can't just sit around and wait forever. Eventually, a hitscan battle is going to happen, and the team who focuses it and aims better on it typically wins. And it's sort of just out of the tank's hand a lot of the time, except for the fact when they play fragging type tanks that can equalize mechanically and can pop off themselves and find frags elsewhere, which I don't think leads to the worst type of gameplay. I think the game plays fairly well, but you can see how the power has shifted away from that team focus and instead into pop-off focus if you want to win. It's going to annoy some of you for me to bring this up again, but there are still quite a lot of power-crept characters that haven't been addressed, that even though they may not be breaking the meta, they are punishing the tank role. This goes for like half of the DPS characters, where yes, we've toned back the range damage thankfully, but there's still a lot of brawly mid-range guaranteed tank punish characters in the DPS lineup, whether it's Reaper reloading after Wraith, making him hard to punish. They gave that effect to Mei, who also has multi-freeze. Sombra's damage went up. Hanzo has a lunge. So many of these characters are stronger than they were in the original version of Overwatch. In some ways, in a good way, I think it's more fun to play them, but it also takes some of the gameplay out of the tank player's hands, where they used to be able to run over a Hanzo or a Torb just with the positioning and targeting alone. The tank could carry a lot of that, but that's not good enough against a lot of these picks. And then on top of that, with your shields being weaker, it's harder to protect from something getting an angle on a Discord orb or to block a sleep or a nade coming in. That's why I'm finding Ana so easy and why I rate Ana as maybe the single best ranked character in the game. Because if you know how to time those abilities and set them up, they can win every team fight until they deal with you. That's how powerful they are. Tanks don't have anything like that. Landing a good anti every fight feels as impactful as landing an Earth Shatter every fight right now. That's how weak Earth Shatter is and how powerful Nade is, especially when there's so little defenses against it. Now, in truth, I actually think this is a fairly good place for the game to be. It might take a bit of patience from me to go back into the tank role, understanding how the meta is playing out, so I don't just catch L's everywhere. But I think with a combination of the community getting better at understanding map control and getting value out of their characters, as well as maybe me getting a bit better at the pop-off tanks, it'll be more smooth sailing. But I think the beauty of the game playing this way is that it is very skill intensive. I don't necessarily want us to go back to a world where tanks are so powerful that they cover up mistakes for teammates all the time. What tanks being worse and the weakest role right now has done to the game is reveal how little Overwatch players know about Overwatch, or at least playing it competitively, right? And this is why I've been hard at work making more detailed map guides, because I think that's what the community desperately needs right now based on the gameplay I've been seeing. Because the squishy battle is so important and tanks' resources are so light, it is at utmost important that the whole team fights for those power positions on the map that sets up for those squishy character abilities to land value. They do the most. Whether it's a Widowmaker angle for a headshot, or Zen contributing on an angle, or Ana landing an ability, or many, many others, if you are not playing the map in order to establish that map control, and the enemy does, it is basically impossible to win, which in some ways is really good. I think there's a lot of players that are going to be losing SR without this game sense, and then hopefully as we work on it as a community, players that know the game better will command the better positions, and they will rise in SR. I'm gonna call out to you guys to send in replays for two particular playstyles that I don't think are going anywhere. For upcoming guide content, we recently did one on Reinhardt, where you guys seem to find that incredibly helpful. There's two more I wanna do, but I also wanna pace myself. I'm gonna ask you guys to study this video, especially with the gameplay in the background and the text on screen, to try to help explain the plays that I've been making. Absorb the importance of popping off as a support. You'll probably lose some SR in this next week or two trying to implement that into your play. And then afterward, later on, I'll ask you guys to submit replays and we'll make a more detailed guide on that. But first, for now, what I want to move to is the DPS position. Yes, hit scans. I want you to submit replay codes of the dominant hit scan characters in the game. The ranged ones, of course. Widowmaker, Ashe, Soldier, and McCree. All four are applicable, and they sort of show better examples of different aspects of the ranged DPS position, but a lot of the rules are still the same for hit scan and are similar to this playmaking map control philosophy to how Overwatch is playing. So the lessons be discussed about Ana here goes for hit scans as well. It's just DPS only play for kills, whereas Ana also can heal. But either way, we're talking about similar things. So we're gonna round those up and make a really deep ranged hit scan guide that will cover mechanics and game sense. So click the Google Form link to submit that information, and I'll get working on that as soon as I can. Be sure to leave the video with a like and hit subscribe so you don't miss out on those future videos and guides. And click the bell icon so that you actually get notified when they come out. That's been it for me. I've been Furido for Your Overwatch. We'll see you guys next time.